I am Rajeev Arora, founder of Amrapali Jewels. See, we started Amrapali in 1978 with my partner, Mr. Rajesh Ajmera. We both were studying history in Rajasthan University, and we thought that we should start something which is very close to our art, culture and crafts of Rajasthan and of India. So the theme came in mind that we should start with some handicraft product, and what should be the name of the company. And we both were much inspired by this character Amrapali in ancient Indian history, who was a courtesan and was also a contemporary to Lord Buddha. She used to live in Vaishali, and she was famous around the world, around her territory, for her beauty and her capacity and skills in dancing. So she was a beautiful dancer. Also, she was a very, very intelligent woman. She was the first woman disciple of Lord Buddha. So we thought that Amrapali is the perfect name for the company to start. See, we started with handicrafts, but slowly everything which was made and produced in Rajasthan, in Jaipur, we were dealing in, whether it's paintings or ivory or sandalwood or wooden crafts or brass items. Once we found some old pieces of silver jewelry which were used in remote areas, in villages in Rajasthan, and we thought that we should transform them into very, very interesting designs. And we started making one of a kind earrings and necklaces. And to surprise to us also, at that time, people appreciated what we created. And slowly Amrapali became very famous for its old tribal silver jewelry, which was very unique, and every single piece was made from old tribal pieces. I think the uniqueness, because we also studied the market, and because my background of history and I did MBA afterwards, we also traveled in different parts of the country, also went abroad and saw what people like, and now we also started realizing that Indian women is also becoming very fashion conscious. And also there was a vogue, there was a fashion of traditional dresses, ethnic dresses, and the jewelry made with old tribal silver was suited perfectly at that time. And we also started working with designers like Neelam Joli, Tarun Telyani, Sunit Verma at that time, and they were also using Amrapali pieces for their shows, for their fashion, for the great events. And this became quite popular, and many celebrities like Kiran Thakur Singh, now she's Kiran Kher, or Reena Roy, they started visiting a small Amrapali shop which was in a by lane of MI Road. And ambassadors of different countries, they started coming, and they started picking what we were selecting from all over India. The most important point was, when we traveled to villages, we found that Indian silver was never hallmarked. So first of all, you never get the idea how old it is. And other thing was, when there was not a good year for monsoon, like there's a drought or famine, or there's a marriage in the family, they used to sell their silver jewelry to either a bullion merchant or a sarafa trader or a jeweler, and they used to recycle the whole thing. So we were also losing our masterpieces, you know, they were being melted all the time. We wanted to create awareness. We told these silversmiths and jewelers, please collect old pieces, because first you bring to us, we'll give you better rate than you get after melting and getting as a silver, as a bullion. And that way we started collecting old interesting pieces. From that point, when I found two or three good pieces, I thought I should not sell. I should start keeping one piece on one side as a collection, because that will be very useful for future generations. The concept of Amrapali Museum started 30 years back at that time, when we started making the collection. And slowly we went to travel to Gujarat and Maharashtra and South India, all over the country, also in the remote areas in Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh, and also in Orissa. We found very, very interesting pieces. We tried to sell some pieces as it is. Rest we tried to design in our way, which we used to do. And slowly there was such a huge demand that I had to start manufacturing those pieces again, replicas or pieces inspired by those designs. So Amrapali became a very, very important name in Indian jewelry, especially in the field of silver jewelry at that time. It was a very, very humble start. We had very small money to start with, because my father was a lawyer and grandfather was a doctor. So I come from a professional's family. My partner's family was also, his grandfather was a doctor and father was a gemstone dealer. We never took any help from our families, but we worked really hard. We used to travel maybe 3-4 times in a week to Delhi or Mumbai to sell our art pieces, which we used to collect from Jaipur or which we used to commission to make for a specific order. And so it took first 3-4 years to start with silver jewelry, but afterwards we were really lucky because we were selling very well what we were creating. It was selling very good, and the first store was starting in 1989 in Mumbai in the Oberoi Hotel Shopping Center. See, when we started manufacturing jewelry in Jaipur, there was no infrastructure at all. Jaipur was very important center for cutting and polishing gemstones, but not for silver jewelry, not for gold jewelry. So it was very difficult to cut a particular stone in that shape which we wanted. There were no karigars at that time. There was not an organized factory, not a plating plant. So initially we had to work really hard, and that's why when we were established little bit, we started first manufacturing unit in Sitapura. When we started exporting silver jewelry from Jaipur, it was in few thousands rupees at that time. Jaipur was hardly on any map of the world where people used to go and buy silver jewelry or gold jewelry. But I am proudly say now that 50% of the silver jewelry export from the country is now from Jaipur. And a lot of contribution goes to Amrapali because we traveled, we make really world-class pieces, we went to different stores, we did a lot of promotions with departmental stores like Galeries Lafayette in Paris, La Printemps in Paris, Liberty in London, Globus in Switzerland, and also make those buyers to come to India, come to Jaipur and explore the market. And I'm really happy that now there are more than 300 very organized jewelry manufacturing units is in Jaipur, and also providing a lot of employment to silversmiths and goldsmiths. See, when you start growing, there always problem was there. You know, there was a Gold Control Act before. The government regulations were not in favor of exporting at that time. It was a difficult time, and India required a lot of foreign currency. So we thought that as an exporter, we are the real son of India, because we work hard, we used to carry our samples, used to go to different places. It was difficult to travel internationally because the FTA allowance was too low, how to travel, how to work. But after 1991, when the government liberalized the whole economy, I think that was a big boost for jewelry industry also. And we also used that opportunity for the growth of Amrapali. And when government started export-oriented units, we also started our first export-oriented unit, and then we started our unit in a special economic zone. So when the government policies were relaxed, they were more business-friendly, I think it made India also becoming an important center of jewelry manufacturing. When we started dealing in silver jewelry, it was in early 80s, say 83, 84, so it's almost 30 years from now. I used to make all the earrings which were made at that time because we had no workforce. So by my own hand, we used to make one of a kind earrings and necklaces. And afterwards, we started also designing. And slowly, people started coming to us that they would like to work as designers with Amrapali. And now we are lucky that students from NIFT, Gandhinagar, and NIG, Ahmedabad, they also approach us. they take their internship in Amrapali companies, and also afterwards they join as designers. So now we have a design studio in our factory, and very, very qualified, very talented, bugging designers are working with Amrapali, but they need to understand the sensibility of Amrapali design concept. And if they work in that parameters, I think they get a lot of opportunities, because we are the only jewelry design company in the world which makes a jewelry for $5 to $50,000. So we make a base metal jewelry for $5, and we also make diamond Kundan Meena jewelry for $40,000 to $50,000 also. So it's a huge exposure, huge variety, and also our customers are not only in India, but around the world, around the globe, from China to Africa and from USA to USSR. So I think that also gives my design team to work with different designers and for different looks. My first year turnover was few thousand rupees, because we started in October 78, and slowly it went up to few lakhs of rupees, and then slowly few crores of rupees. It was step by step growth of Amrapali as company, as a design house, as an internationally renowned Indian jewelry brand. But for me, numbers were never important. The turnover was not important. The important was whether I can provide employment to people, whether I can get foreign currency for this country, whether I can make India as an important player in the world jewelry market. And that somehow we have achieved for some extent, but the journey is still on. I have much more dreams in my life, much in my mind, in my vision, and I would like to accomplish them with the help of my partner and also with my son and daughter-in-law, Tarang and Akanksha, who has joined the business with new ideas. And I think now Amrapali is really a company on strong pillars, and we have yet to achieve the best. Yeah, Calvin Klein came to India, he visited Amrapali, and also was very much impressed by our collection of old Indian textile, which was basically Banjara and tribal textile. And he wanted to take some inspiration and make the new line of his home furnishing with that concept in mind, India in the background. Fortunately, the next year was his birthday, and he wanted to talk to the media also in Jaipur. He celebrated the birthday at the Amrapali flagship store, Pajbati MI Road, and it was a very good occasion. Also, we got this opportunity to create a crown for Herrick's window for Queen's Diamond Jubilee celebration. Similarly, recently we were also were in exhibition in Kremlin Museum in Moscow, where Amrapali pieces were especially displayed for their uniqueness and the craftsmanship. Such occasions also give my team lot of enthusiasm to create wonderful pieces in the future. Celebrities like Jennifer Lopez or Shakira or Megan Fox or Drew Barrymore, they are renowned all over the world, but when they visit India, they also visit Amrapali stores. When Mr. Michael Jackson came to India, he also got a gift which was made by Amrapali. When Nelly Furtado came to Bombay, she visited Amrapali store in Bombay. When Lucci Luke came to Bombay, she also visited Amrapali store. So these are Beyonce also, she also visited Amrapali store. So these are the great moments, and we always remember all our lives, you know. Naomi Campbell, she came to Jaipur, she came to Jodhpur, she visited both the stores. She liked Amrapali pieces a lot. For all the occasions, all the functions which they were attending in India, they are wearing Amrapali jewelry. So I think for a designer, I think this gives a lot of satisfaction. And also, we try to make more important, more interesting pieces for future. So this kind of publicity which Amrapali jewelry, also Indian jewelry, is getting all over the world, should continue. See, we started our first store out of Jaipur in Mumbai in 1989, and afterwards almost every year We started, we opened stores somewhere small, somewhere bigger, some franchisees, some Amrapali run stores. But we are so happy that now Amrapali is all important major cities in the country, whether it's Delhi, Mumbai, Bangalore, Chennai or Kolkata. Also we have stores in London and also office in New York. This gives, first of all, Amrapali has international exposure. Also, our clients can visit there. And recently we started our online business because I feel that every Indian woman should have one Amrapali piece. With online business, with e-commerce, you can reach to remote areas, to smaller cities in this country, also around the globe. And I am really happy that we have just completed 1 year and it has been a very, very successful venture for us. We started e-commerce with a special name, trybyamrapali.com, because always Amrapali designs are inspired by ancient Indian culture, ancient world culture. Also, we have taken a lot of inspirations from our tribal designs, their motifs, and whenever I create a piece which can be very international or universal in look, which can look very beautiful with a Mexican or Moroccan dress, also very good with Indian sari or Indian salwar suit. The look may be international, but soul is and always will be very Indian, because I take all my inspiration from our architecture, from paintings, from sculptures, from jalis, what I see around me. And when we travel, I really try to understand how it was made. And we are so lucky that we live in this country, India, where there's a tradition of jewelry manufacturing from last 5,000 years. From Indus Valley Civilization to 2014, we have seen fantastic silversmithing, fantastic gold smithing. Whenever you go to museums, whenever you go to old houses, havelis or palaces, you see such fantastic work. I also want that our new students, new designers, they should also study and always try to take inspiration what India has. Then only you can also be successful. Because if you start making things only with machines or with CAD CAM or computer aided designing, you will be competing with China, Thailand or Italy. There will be no individuality. People like hand craftsmanship, which is getting rare. And also I want to give this message to workers, to carriers who are looking for white collar job. I think we have so much we have got in inheritance. We should revive the art which was dying, like art of enameling. And also because there's lot of good opportunities in this field, in jewelry designing field, jewelry manufacturing field, people should come up, because India has the potential to become the world jewelry hub. See, when we used to travel in India, we used to find very interesting pieces which I wanted to collect. And this collection is now become one of the most important Indian tribal silver jewelry collection. Few years back, there was an organization, Shisha, in UK. They took as loan this collection, also exhibited in 6 different museums in England. And now we want to make a museum in Jaipur with silver jewelry and Indian silver smithing. And I'm sure that this will give a new perspective. Also, we are coming with a new catalog of the museum collection. Many of the pieces are not published ever. So people will come to know that which kind of jewelry was worn, in which area, in which state, by which community or which religion, and why they used to wear it. Because in India, when you wear a jewelry piece, there is always some history behind it. So I want to tell that also, and I don't want that this knowledge which I have acquired in last 35 years should go wasted. It should be documented, and also it will become an important center for research, for designers to come, and also the other museums, they can also, people can come from them, from a museum in US or UK or Australia, if they want to study about Indian jewelry, Indian art. So this will become an important center in Jaipur. And Jaipur being in such an important tourist destination, people, they come here, they really want to go and visit museums. We have few museums, but if you go to Paris or Geneva, you'll find hundreds of museums of different art, primitive art. So there's no museum of silver jewelry in India. So I want to make an important point, an important destination in my favorite city, Jaipur, which we also want to make a brand around the world for its craftsmanship, also for its art. My advice to youngsters and people who want to be successful in this business is that there is no substitute of hard work. So never shy. Do work with your own hand, also your dedication to your cause, because passion is very, very important when you want to create something nice. And also discipline. You will have to be disciplined on yourself, what you are creating, and also foresightedness. You create what people will create after 3 years or 5 years. So I think if you keep these four points in your mind, you will be always successful. See, we are friends from last 40 years?
Yes.
71.
Yeah, from 1971. We are studying together and did all the exams together and spent time in the canteen and in the university. The times were very different at that time. And then slowly, later on, when we thought what we have to do in future, our lives were different. My family was in jewelry business and his family was all professional. So in order to do something together, we thought to stay together, we should start some business. So that's how we started business and staying on.
Yeah, because we wanted to work with art and had no investment to do. So we thought we'll work hard, and if there are two people, so it's 101, it's 11, I think, not two. So we really worked hard, traveled, like I told you, we used to go to Bombay, Delhi, 3-4 times in a week to sell what we used to manufacture here. Mm-hmm. And slowly business grew, and because we had similar interests, similar taste, I think that helped a lot. And in some part of the business, I think Rajesh is much more strong, whether when we talk about manufacturing, when we talk about designing or administration. And slowly when we started working, he used to concentrate more on manufacturing side and I more on marketing and sales side. See, success is always relative, you know. What we have achieved, we are thankful to God and also to all our well-wishers and our customers who make Amrapali what it is now. But I and Mr. Ajmera also feels that there is a lot to do and a lot to achieve, because I always feel that this country and particularly our city of Jaipur has a lot of potential, a lot of possibilities. It is the land of opportunities, and if we combine the craftsmanship of Jaipur and also skills of cutting and polishing stones and manufacturing, India can become the world jewelry hub.